All right, I think that's everything out of this bombed out shithole.
I hope so. I don't want to be here anymore.
I don't either. It's scary to be in. The hazmat crew is expensive.
Well, look at what we've got here.
Oh, hi.
This is no Tunisia. This ain't real fancy digs like we got at Chungus HQ. What y'all got here? It looks real empty.
Yeah.
It looks like your winning record. Am I right?
Yeah, it kind of smells like loser in here, but it might be a draft. I don't know. Could be the local flora and fauna. But
and look, you got Spencer here. That's cute.
That is
No. That's Travis.
That's
Travis.
Oh, sorry, Travis. My bad.
Well, just like your ability to memorize my roster, you got bad intel. This isn't even our HQ anymore. So
are you sure? Because I had a. Are you sure? Where's the note? I had a note here. Oh, nope. That's all I had. That it just kind of directed me here. Said Charming. This was your base.
Charming. Fucking got him. Am I right?
Love the dabs. Love the dabs. No. Again, as per usual, y'all have shit intel. I'm happy you decided to pay a visit ahead of the ass whooping you're receiving, but we're just getting some last minute move out stuff taken care of.
Wow. Where are you headed?
Latrobe?
You don't need to know that.
It's Latrobe. He's going to shoot.
Confidential gentleman.
He's going to Latrobe. Shout out Latrobias. Latrobians, including the mountain Latrobians as well.
The mountain?
I don't even know, dude.
What's a fucking mountain Latrobian?
There's the Wakandans, and then there's the Jabari. You guys have like a gorilla Latrobe, as well as a Latrobe original recipe.
It's true. We are experts in this field, so you should take our word for it.
Well, if you can tell me who the mayor of Latrobe is, I'll take your word for it.
You.
Yeah, it's you, Jared.
I have enough on my plate. I'm not engaging with this conversation anymore.
I don't know, man.
Save the shit talk. Save all the talk. Okay. I got nothing to say to you sons of bitches. It's all in the ring tonight. It's so all in
rude.
The ring tonight.
We just came to wish you good luck on this match coming up.
Oh, yeah, talking about it. Tonight. I thought you did this for the love of the game, and now you want to kick us out of your home?
You know what they say, it's all about the game and how you play it.
It's all about control and if you can take it.
Well, the only thing I know about control is Kendrick's control verse, and I'm here to murder all y'all. So
wow.
Get out of here, and I'll see you tonight.
Welcome back to another episode of Star Wars in a Galaxy Epic Confrontations, the show where trivia rivalries and matchups get epic. I am your host and commissioner, Eli, alongside my great co-host, Boop, here.
Yes, here.
And Boop, we have a match and a half today.
We have a match today.
The rivalry between the Chungus Eternal and the Wayseeker Alliance continues in its mighty quest forward. But this time, it is in the team's division. The team's division. Jared the Dark Jedi's 1 year team's ban is up. As of this recording, it has expired. It has expired for around over a week. Around a little bit under a week.
Time isn't real.
And with the unfortunate departure of his once teammate Claire Scribbling from the Wayseeker Alliance,
R.I.P.
he has chosen his co-host on the Nerd Academy podcast, Cason Breon, to be his teammate as they face on an all too familiar enemy. Big Chungus is back after their, and I'm going to insist upon this defeat to Bangers and Smash in January of last year. So again, this is a debuting team versus a team that is 0-1. I want to be very clear about that. So these are both, regardless of the prodigious skill of both these teams, they're both relatively new teams. So that's also going to play into this. Of course, the rivalry is going to play into this. That's the most thing. That's the most important thing of all, I think, really. Is that rivalry between Jared and Alden, specifically between the Iconoclast and the Dark Jedi. But, you know, he has some bad blood with McCoy as well. And Kaysen's going to be in there fighting by his teammate's side against the Chungus Eternal. And we'll see how that goes. Anything else for you to say, Boop?
I mean, Kaysen is America's sweetheart, so we will see how this goes. There will be shots fired on both sides, but hey.
Yeah, we're expecting it.
That's par for the course, baby. That's showbiz.
Yeah, that's how we do this. All right.
That's what we're here for.
It's time for an epic confrontation. Introducing first. Representing the Wayseeker Alliance, Jared the Dark Jedi, and Kaysen. And Kaysen, Bantha Fodder Kid, Freon. I've been trained to bust when a stranger first trying to win the Jedi. Praise me, y'all. Phase me, y'all. When they see me, they gaze me, y'all.
Crazy, y'all. They say I'm a myth. Trust me. I want to be mean mugging. It's kind of hard when I got Big Will bumping in my ears. I was not the music I was anticipating hearing. And you know what? It got me ready. It got me in the place I need to be. And it's fucking showtime. I said it on Twitter and I'll reiterate it here in Kaysen. I'm sorry that you could not be in a normal fucking match for your first one. I apologize to you for that. This is not about tonight. This is not about the love of the game. This is not about fun. This is not about sportsmanship. This is personal. I want to make motherfuckers cry tonight. Let's rock and roll.
And their opponents. Representing the Chungus Eternal. The current reigning number one contender, Alden the Iconoclast Diaz. The Eye of the Storm, Michael McCoy, with a record of no wins and one defeat. Big Chungus.
All right. That's enough of our music. Guys, song I'm feeling really, anyway. I'm going to take that criticism to heart because I like you. I'm feeling really good, and Michael and I were talking, and I think he has something that he wants to share.
That's right. Jared, you know what? You talked a lot about sportsmanship and our conduct in this league. And yes. So for this match, Jared, we have a dedication. We wanted to dedicate this match to you, our friend. Here's
Jared,
to you, buddy.
Can we get a round of applause for Jared? It's dead serious. Can we get a round of applause for the hardest working player in the league? Most matches, most points scored.
Kaysen, clap.
Absolutely thunderous. Kaysen, why aren't you clapping for this man? All right, maybe Kaysen's not feeling it. Look, guys, we want to start a new chapter in Chungus that starts tonight. We're leaving our devilish, dastardly ways in the past. It's about the love of the game tonight.
What dastardly ways we're talking about.
Maybe it's just it's time to move forward.
Dick Dastardly himself.
I wore my lightest pair of glasses that I own for this. I want it to be a fresh chapter. Jared, I know we've burned a lot of bridges in the city that is our relationship. That tonight it's gonna change.
I'll say this much. At some point tonight, I will be performing an original song I created just for you in your honor. Love you, buddy. Let's do this. I'm excited.
Game on, baby. Best.
I don't want to start the match.
Best teams.
The only thing keeping me sane right now is that I know the month we are playing this match in.
No. Look, spring is about blooming. It's about new things emerging after a cold winter. It's time to stop bringing toxicity into this space. I've been looking at people's Twitters, and there are people out there that want to create positive environments. And it's time to change.
It's time we live up to our good morals, you know? And Jerry, you've come so much further than most people in this league. Like all the things you went through with Cookie Cop and Scotty and all that. And the fact that you've come out on the other side.
It's inspiring.
And now you come out of your team's band too. Dude, I'm so proud of you. And it is truly an honor to come up against the Dark Jedi.
And honestly, like after I'm sorry, we're going to let you talk, but like, just like the way that you have dealt with Scotty in particular, who is a fucking menace. Like we all know this. And maybe we took after him too much, but it's definitely time to embrace fun, because you know, because
that's what matters most. No matter who wins, we all win. You know.
Yeah, because we've seen some people maybe like get hurt by the game or whatever and walk away, and like that we don't want that. And so it's time for everybody to unite. And like Kaysen brings like a newness and like a light and a friendship and like a musicality. Like this man took off a night of work, like managing the band to mm-hmm. like be here. Like it's time for goodness. All right, let's get it started.
This is the Republic Fair. This is the spirit of unity. We are all the epic confrontation.
Yeah, let's do it.
Everybody else heard all of that, right? I'm not hallucinating, because either I'm hallucinating or these two gentlemen, and I use that term with the loosest definition, deserve a fucking Oscar.
Jared, we understand that we have to earn the trust.
The switch up from actual Robbie Rottens, both of you, to we are all number one is absolutely insane.
We're ready.
I can't believe I'm hearing this.
We're ready to make a change, man. Like, we're ready to earn this. It's not just about, you know, it can't always be Star Wars. It can't always be Star Wars and we just get redeemed. It's not that.
All right, let's do this. Three rounds to the finish. Here we go.
Gas leak in this room right now.
The rules of round one are as follows. Each competitor will receive 10 questions from different parts of the Star Wars universe. I don't think there are any big canon updates this month, so competitors will have 15 seconds to write down the answer or an answer when applicable to the question on a whiteboard or whatever you got as equivalent. When the time runs out, I'll ask each competitor to turn over their whiteboard and reveal their answer while also saying the answer. You cannot confer with your teammate in this round. Each question in round one is worth 1 point. No opportunities for stealing or to receive multiple choice options for any question in the first round. During the duration of the match, each team also has 4 usages of question repeats. Misheard a question, want 15 more seconds to buy you time? Use a question repeat. You also have the use of a challenge, which can be used if you feel something is wrong about how a question is written or answered. Knew this match, I think, for all these competitors, is the new benchmark for getting your bonus question. The Schmodown, and for many previous EC matches, we required all 10 questions. We have now lowered it to 7. 7 correct questions and to receive a bonus.
So do both people on the team have to get it correct? Get 7 questions correct?
No. So, for example, if Michael, if you get 7 correct and Alden gets 6, for example, you will be allowed to answer the question, but Alden will not be.
Got it.
So a bonus is up to 2.
Yes. Yes, correct. All right. So, all right. Boop, I think it's time. We do this. You ready with our first question?
I'm ready. The vibes are in shambles, but I'm ready. All right. So, first question. In the category of A New Hope, Obi-Wan tells Luke that his father was the best what in the galaxy? Five. 4, 3, 2, 1.
Jared?
Pilot.
You know what?
I also had this moment. And
Kaysen?
I wrote a second word, but
Star Pilot.
Michael?
Star Pilot, written in Jared's favorite color.
Star Pilot. But I almost wrote Pilot. So
here's my thing. I just realized that I did not write whether or not a direct quote for
give
this
Jared
question.
I'm gonna give Jared the point,
but yeah, that was my bad. 2-2 so far. 2-2 so far.
Good job, Jared.
Stop.
Jared. Oh, God.
Jared.
Okay. All right.
Jared.
The category of the holotables. And your question is, the story of Jedi Survivor ends on what planet?
Guess it depends on how much New Game Plus you played, but...
Am I right?
I have a feeling I know what Eli's going for here.
4, 3, 2...
Jared, extra points if you scream it.
Tantalor!
That's correct. Kaysen?
I didn't know, so I just wrote Kashyyyk.
Michael?
Tantalor! Just like Jared said.
And all.
I don't think I could yell it as good as Jared, so I'm just going to say it's Tantalor. It's Dagan Gera Business's favorite planet.
It is the planet that Dagan Gera Business is obsessed with. That is 4-3. 4-3, Chungus up by 1. All right, third question. Go ahead.
All right, in category Solo. On board the first light, Kira asks server Autilly if she has been attentive to which dealer on the planet of Batuu.
Always love this stuff when they cross canon so effectively like this.
For sure.
A great early example.
And Mark.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
And Jared.
Doc Ondar?
That's correct.
Yeet. Jason? This is for Scotty. Whiff.
Michael?
I put a sad face because I didn't know.
Oh. And Alden.
But you know, that's okay because I was right there with my boy Jared. It's Doc Ondar.
All right.
So good job, Jared.
5-4.
I'm not your fucking boy. Have you heard, did you forget all the shit you've said to me? The shit you caused in the last match that you rabbit sons of bitches were in? No. Fuck
Jared,
your
you're
boy.
3-3. Whoa. Why are you upset?
Yeah, like, you're on a hot streak right now. You're doing so good.
5-4. All right. Next question is in the category of Padawan Journeys. The Young Jedi Adventures episode Charhound Chase was written by which High Republic author? Charhound Chase on this week's episode, or the week I'm recording this, on this week's episode of Star Wars in the Galaxy. Very excited.
That is a great question, and I'm excited.
4, 3, 2.
And Jared.
It's not Charles Soule, is it?
It is not Charles Soule. Kaysen?
Fuck!
I do not know.
Michael.
This is a guess. I said Justina Ireland.
That's also incorrect. And Alden.
It is the lovely Kavin Scott.
It is indeed Kavin Scott. 6-4. 6-4 so far. 6-4.
I didn't know that. That's interesting.
All right.
Indeed.
Next question.
In the category Star Wars Rebels, name one of the surviving Lasat that the Ghost Crew meets in the episode Legends of the Lasat.
Oh,
that's a good question.
That's an excellent question.
What the fuck is that doing in round one?
Jared, I think you're right about the difficulty of that. And that's as a Rebels fan. Like
4, 3, 2, 1.
And Jared.
Gammy Num Num.
Kaysen.
That's a really funny answer, Jared.
I also had Gammy Num Num.
That is so specific.
3-3 on Grammy Num Num.
You guys aren't gonna fucking believe this. I wrote
no.
Grammy Num Num.
No.
What you movie too? Is that from, Michael? Tell me right now.
Alden.
I wrote Grammy Num Num too. Shockingly, I mean, I just
the two villain slots names are Shava and Gron.
Gron. Mm.
Next question.
He rizzed down Baby Livy down in Ohio.
Christ.
Next question in the category of behind the scenes. Before he went on to star in Indiana Jones and the Dial of Destiny, which actor had a supporting role in Rogue One, appearing on the planets Lamu and Edu?
This is question 6, right?
Yep.
Okay. Just making sure my numbering is correct. This is a great question. Love getting some indie in there.
4, 3, 2, 1. Every time I start the countdown,
Jared.
Mads Mikkelsen.
That's correct. And Kaysen.
I did not know.
Michael.
It's my favorite Hannibal Lecter, Mads Mikkelsen.
And Alden.
It is the other Grindelwald, Mads Mikkelsen.
Yes, it
is. Keeping track.
It is the other Grindelwald, yes.
What? I mean,
You're back on your winning streak. Good job, bud.
Remember when...
There's King, man.
Remember when... Sorry, I was just thinking about this. Remember when somebody got fired off of a Harry Potter movie, but it somehow wasn't J.K. Rowling?
Incredible.
All right. Next question, Boop.
In the category of Return of the Jedi, complete Palpatine's line to Luke. Good. Your hate has made you powerful. Now fulfill your destiny and take your father's place. And this is a direct quote.
We need the direct quote for this.
This is a great question. One of the best scenes.
Jared, you got spared because I was going to do my impression.
Yeah. You do got spared, Jared.
Yeah, I was not going to try.
And take your father's place at my side.
Oh, that's yeah, correct. Palpatine impressions.
That was like Whitworth level, dude. That was good.
At my side.
That's correct. And Michael.
At my side.
And Alden.
Take your father's plate at my side.
Fantastic. All right. So
I almost messed it up and said by my side, but I got it right.
Count right now is 10-7. 10-7. Chungus in the lead by 3. Next question. Revenge of the Sith. Clone pilot Jag shoots down which Jedi master in the skies of Cato Nemoidia?
This hurts, man. This hurts a little.
One more for the Iconoclast to get a bonus round, and two more for the Dark Jedi to get a bonus
round. 2-1.
All right, and Jared.
Plo Koon.
That's correct. Kaysen.
I couldn't remember.
Michael.
Plo Koon.
And Alden.
Patron saint of the Plo's Bros. Plo Koon.
Hell yeah.
That's
dude.
Correct.
Crazy.
All right. Poop will read the question, but the category is
Sacred Jedi Texts.
Ooh. Read them, have you? Well, I'm mage turners. They were not.
What species was Nile Tempest Runner Pan Ada?
This is one of a select few questions I call Michael Bait.
Pan Ada.
See?
That is why I wrote that question.
Amazing.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
And Jared.
He's the Dewotan run, right?
He is. Kaysen?
No idea.
Michael?
He is one of my favorite species, Dewotan.
And Alden?
Indeed, a Dewotan.
All right.
Jared, you're fucking killing it, man.
So we have, let's see, we have 8, oh, let's see, plus 14 to Game. 9. 14 to 9. As we approach our final question in the standard round before we get to the bonus question to see who gets to answer that. And that question is from the Clone Wars film. When Ahsoka is feeling discouraged on Teth, which Jedi Master from the prequel trilogy does Anakin quote to her?
You repeat the question.
Yes, it's one to repeat. The question is, when Ahsoka is feeling discouraged on Teth, which Jedi Master from the prequel trilogy does Anakin quote to him? To her.
Great question.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
And Jared.
Qui-Gon Jinn.
That's correct.
Oh! And
Kaysen.
I don't know.
Michael.
I completely guessed and got it right, just like my best friend Jared, Qui-Gon.
Damn!
And Alden.
I was off. I guessed Luminara unduly. I did not.
All right, so here's where we stand. Jared, Michael, and Alden will all be answering the bonus question for an extra point.
Good job, Jared.
Here we go. So, in the category of the Clone Wars series, what supplies does Hondo give to the Onderon rebels on Anakin's dime in the episode Tipping Points? You can be like general with this. We're not looking for specifics.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
And Jared.
Explosives?
I'm going to give that to you. If they challenge, I might hear it. Michael?
I said missile launchers.
Yeah, that's closer. Yeah.
Okay.
I put ammo or munitions or... I put ammo. I wrote ammo.
I'm not sure I can... The specific was rocket launchers. I'm more inclined to give it because they are explosives to Jared.
That does count as an explosive.
Yeah, it does. I'm not sure if I can give that to Alden, so...
Okay.
Hey, you win some, you lose some. It's all good, and we're all having fun. Right, Jared?
Spirit of the game, baby.
Do we want to sub someone else in for me?
We're going to see this through.
You're staying.
Don't let that psychopath Scotty talk shit to you in the chat.
16-11.
Pressure makes diamonds. 11. Pressure makes fucking diamonds.
Look at this diamond we got here on the other side of us. What a king. Can I sing my song now?
16-11 as we go into the second round. This would be a great time
for a song.
Okay, here's my song, Jared. Are you ready? It's called Jared, We're So Proud of You. Let's go, Jared. We're so proud of you. Let's go, Jared. We're so proud of you. Alden, take it away.
Let's go, Jared. We're so proud of you. Let's go, Jared. And you should be too. Hey!
Derivative. I hate it.
You know, they can't all be top 40 hits right off the bat, but we'll get there.
But hey, what matters is the heart we put into it because of the heart we have for our friend.
As Chungus is in the lead by 5 points, you get to choose whether you spin the wheel first or defer to your opponents.
We gotta let Jared go first, right?
Of course, dude. King yeah. Jared, go, bud.
Jared, I also am excited to see Kaysen's first wheel. This is huge.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Kaysen, he is right about that. He is right about that. This is a momentous occasion.
All right, let's do this. Wheel spin number one. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Oh my god.
Wow.
Very close.
Tense round so far.
I almost fucking threw up.
Jared, don't be so nervous, bud. You got this.
Suck my puck.
Whoa!
No matter what.
I'm removing them just because you have this time to
chat. Thank you. Kaysen, I'm not gonna lie to you. I would be okay spinning again. Like, I know there's stuff in here I like, but I'd also like us both to be able to hang on this one and really put our minds together.
Whatever you think.
All right, well, let's roll it again.
Ah, Rogue One.
All right.
Rogue One. Of course it gives, of course this wheel gives me the Rogue One questions. I see how it is, wheel. All right. So, here we go.
We also have some peace and quiet now for a little bit. So, everybody...
I'm going to read the rules of round two. I'm going to read the rules of round two, and then I'm going to kick Alden and Michael out. Rules of round two are as follows. Each team will be able to spin the wheel like they just did, to receive a category from which to answer 5 questions. You may choose to re-spin the wheel if you land on anything other than a punch choice. If you land on a punch choice, you have to keep it. Each team will have 15 seconds to answer their questions. You can confer amongst each other to answer said question. Each question in round two is worth 2 points. However, if you feel the option is needed, you can choose to get 4 multiple choice options. If you do, the amount of points you'll get recedes to 1. If you miss a question, no matter how many points the question is worth, the other team has the opportunity to steal the question, collecting the value of the points given. All right, so I'm going to kick... Jared, I'm going to kick Michael and Alden. I'll text you when to get back. So here we go. Yeah. All right. Here we go. Rogue One. I will be asking you your Rogue One questions. Give me a second. Let me just go back to the doc. Okay, here we go. Rogue One question. Question one.
We don't need a whiteboard.
In the category of Rogue One. Again. Cruel that the wheel had me ask these questions. Name one of the Two Tubes brothers.
Benthic.
Is that your final answer?
Final answer.
2 points. 16-13. Question two. Which Imperial project in the database on Scarif is later referenced in the Bad Batch?
That would be... No, it's War Mantle. Because that's an episode title for Bad Batch, and I believe Jin says that. So, you cool with that answer?
Yeah.
Project War Mantle.
That is correct. Another 2 points, 16-15. Chungus will 1 point lead. Next question. After she learns that Jin and her crew went to Scarif, who does Mon Mothma demand to speak to?
I want to say it's Radis. What are you thinking? We can also check down a multiple choice if need be.
I am not super confident, but if you are, then I'm cool with whatever you want to do.
I don't want to give them any points. So you cool checking down?
Don't matter to me, yeah.
All right, cool. We'll go multiple choice.
And your options are A, General Draven, B, Senator Pamlo, C, Admiral Radis, or D, Senator Organa.
Well, Bail's on the base with her. Radis had just left. Draven's an Empire. Radis. We'll go with Radis, C, final answer.
That is correct for a point.
Should have trusted
Next question. Name a vehicle seen in Rogue One that is manufactured by the Incom Corporation.
Can you repeat the question? I did not understand what you said.
Yes. The question is, name a vehicle seen in Rogue One that is manufactured by the Incom Corporation.
I think we'll go multiple choice on this one.
Multiple choice. Your options are A, Y-Wing, B, A-Wing, C, B-Wing, or D, X-Wing.
I want to say Y-Wing.
Comfortable with that?
Comfortable with that? Okay, Y-Wing, final answer.
That is incorrect. Your opponents will have the opportunity to steal.
And
finally, the final question in this category. Category Rogue One, what is the last word spoken in the film?
Hope. Final answer, hope.
That is correct. For 2 points to end this round. Let's see. I believe that is 18-16. Chungus, Jedi Lords up by two. Jedi Lords up by two.
Jared, we're so proud of you. Good
job.
Jared, we're so proud of you.
All right, okay. Well, let's try something different. How about Jedi Lords on A New Day Rocks beat?
Jedi
Lords. Jedi Lords.
All right. So you both have one steal in the category of Rogue One to get for 1 point.
Okay.
And I'll read you the questions and the options and what your opponent choose.
All right.
Name a vehicle seen in Rogue One that is manufactured by the Incom Corporation. And your options are A, Y-Wing, B, A-Wing, C, B-Wing, or D, X-Wing. And your opponents chose A.
Well, it's not Y, and I don't think it would be B because we saw the whole origin of B.
Although the B-Wing, they do send to go manufacture somewhere else. I just don't
That's true. Where. That's true. I trust you on this. You were more of a squadrons guy. I don't know if that triggers anything.
That's not going to affect anything. Yeah. Shot in the dark. Let's just go B-Wing.
Sure. Yeah, let's do it.
That is incorrect. The answer is X-Wing.
Interesting.
Another acceptable answer that I did not put in the multiple choice, also U-Wings would have counted.
I was waiting for you in the multiple choice because I was like, that's the special one for this movie.
Let's get the wheel up here for your spin. Let's do this in a second. Here we go.
Think Jared.
These are perfect. I don't like
this. Saga. The Grogu saga.
I think I like this, Alden.
Terrible fan-made Heir of the Empire poster.
I'm rocking my boy. I got a Grogu tattoo. Like, this is it, man. I got a
little Grogu over here.
A little Grogu. I heard. I'm ready for this. I think this is good.
Let's go.
All right. Boop.
Okay.
So the current score is 18-16 Jedi Lords ahead by 2 points. So, whenever you're ready.
All right.
Hey, Boop, thank you for this, by the way.
Yeah, thank you, Boop.
All right. What is the name of the New Republic soldier killed by Gian in Chapter 6, The Prisoner?
Ooh, so we're talking about Space Matt Lanter here.
Yes.
I think we might need our options on this one, bud. I don't remember.
Yeah, yeah, let's take the options for this guy.
A, Jib Dodger. B, Lance Devon. C, Nilux Cabin Roves. Or D, Sethro Daggle.
I want to say it's B.
My gut said B, too.
Because Jib Dodger is Rick Famuyiwa. So that eliminated that. And the other two just sound fucking ridiculous. If it is one of the other two, I'll laugh. But I think
I can hear Bill Burr being like, Lance, put the gun down, whatever he says. Like
some shit like that. Yeah, yeah. I think it's
let's
B.
Let's go B.
Yeah.
That is correct for 1 point.
All right, all right, all right.
Next question.
Who directed Chapter 21, The Pirate?
That's Peter Ramsey. Final answer.
Final answer.
That's correct. 1918. Next question, Boop.
Good year.
Not for everyone, but...
Of course not. Complete Balin's line to Shin on Peridia. I miss the idea of it, but not the truth. The blank.
Ooh.
Oh.
That's the part that everyone knows.
Yes.
I miss the idea of it, but not the truth. The.
Should we get our options, bud?
I'm willing to multiple this one as well.
Yeah.
Okay. A, arrogance. B, failure. C, weakness. Or D, hubris.
I think it's A or B.
Can we hear those options one more time, please?
Yes. A, arrogance. B, failure. C, weakness. Or D, hubris.
I almost feel like it's weakness.
I know. When I heard it a second time, I'm like, I can almost kind of hear that in Balin's voice.
Are you comfortable with weakness?
Let's go for it.
All right. We're going to say weakness.
That is correct for another point.
Dude, you're fucking killing it. That's that Jared energy right there.
Channeling it, man.
Sorry, Jared and Kaysen energy. Kaysen's killing it, too.
So let's see. That is 2017.
Good year.
All right. Next question.
Actually, maybe not. Good year for Star Wars.
That's true.
All right. Who says, in difficult times, fear is a surer bet in the Book of Boba Fett?
I feel like that's a Fennec Shan.
I was going to say, that's very Fennec.
Yeah, let's go Fennec Shan.
That is correct for another 2 points. 22-17. And then finally.
What planet does the Chimera enter the system of after it returns to the main Star Wars galaxy?
That's Dathomir, right?
Dathomir, yeah.
Dathomir.
That is correct for yet another 2 points. 24-17. All right, here we go. Here's where we stand. Going into the final round, the Big Chungus has a 7-point lead, 24-17. So going into round three.
But hey, don't call it a comeback. Jared?
That's okay. I'm having fun with my friends.
That's right.
They're not with the spirit of the game.
Dude, yes. And by my friends,
fucking friends.
And by my friends, I mean Jared, Boop, and Eli, of course.
Whoa. All right. Well,
that's right.
Trust is earned. Trust is earned.
That's right. Anyway.
Exactly.
The rules of round three are as follows. Each team will select three numbers between 1 and 20. Both teams must choose different numbers than their opposing team. Each number chosen will correspond to a certain category of question. The questions will be worth 2, 3, and 5 points, respectively. The team must choose one point competitor to answer the 2-point question, and the other will answer the 3-point question, and they may collaborate on the 5-point question. You'll have 15 seconds to each answer each question. No stealing or multiple choice available in round three. Both of you have both teams have 3 repeats left. As you're in the lead, Chungus, please pick your 3 numbers first.
Shall we leave it to chance, Alden?
I actually had a thought.
Okay.
I think we should let Jared and Kaysen choose our numbers.
That's a great idea. Jared.
Like, Kaysen. I love the power of the dice, and I know Jared does too. Maybe Jared can roll his dice.
That's a great charges. Idea. Jared, you have your D20 on you?
I happen to.
Yes! Yes! Yes!
This is a circle.
Oh, man, this is awesome. I trust Jared implicitly. So, this is going to be
awesome. I would put my life in Jared's hand. So my trivia fate, of course I would leave it in his hand.
Jared has me, Michael, and Kaysen in his arms.
You know, I'm starting to think that this is not just a prank on Jared. I think this is also a prank on us, too, Naboo.
I think so.
Certainly not.
There's not an ounce of malice in the heart of the Chungus.
That's true. We have been purified.
I'm not a religious man. You should have been struck down by God for saying that.
God's dead and they killed him.
First number 10.
All right.
9. 2.
8? Oh, okay. Right.
10, 9, 2, and then Jared and Kaysen.
You want me to keep rolling, Cray? I think you're muted, but I think you said yes. Okay.
Yeah, go for it.
Yeah. 19, 5. Roll again. That was another 9, 8.
All right. Good numbers. Here we go.
Shut the fuck up.
Category 19. To catch up to Big Chungus Eternal. The Jedi Lords. To catch up to Big Chungus, the Jedi Lords must answer at least their 3 and 5 question. The 3 and 5 question correctly. Although the 2 point we're still going to do, the 2 point question is in category 19, which is the category, wait a second. Okay. The category of the Empire Strikes Back.
Ooh, nice pause there.
Kaysen, you want it?
Kaysen, yeah.
Yeah, I'll take that.
Okay.
All right. Cool. For 2 points. To stay in the match. To further stay in the match, at least. What is Han's response to a rebel officer saying that his Tauntaun won't reach the first marker?
Five, four, three, two.
If you're writing, you don't have to.
Yeah, you don't have to write.
Oh, I thought I had to write. Oh.
Yeah, no, you don't have to write.
I'm not 100% sure, but I'm going to say never tell me the odds.
That is incorrect.
I don't remember where that's placed.
Then I'll see you in hell.
Would it fit, though?
It would.
All right. Jared is answering the 3-pointer for Category 5. Category 5 is Revenge of the Sith.
Okay.
Complete the Palpatine quote. See, you're not done with me, Palpatine, yet. Complete the Palpatine quote. The Sith and the Jedi are similar in almost every way, including their quest for. I need the direct words after this.
How many words?
I'll give you that. It's 2.
Oh, fuck me. Wait, hold on. Repeat
the
question.
Repeat if you have to.
I'm fucking aware. Thank you.
All right, your question for 3 points and to stay in the match. Complete the Palpatine quote. The Sith and the Jedi are similar in almost every way, including their quest for...
God.
5.
Repeat the question.
All right, that is your you have one repeat left. Your question for 3 points is complete the Palpatine quote. The Sith and the Jedi are similar in almost every way, including their quest for.
How many repeats do I have?
1.
Three, 2.
Repeat the question.
All right. That your final your final repeat of the question, and here it is. Complete Palpatine's quote in Revenge of the Sith. The Sith and the Jedi are similar in almost every way, including their quest for...
greater knowledge?
And your winners! Big Chungus! Greater power!
You fucking fool! You buffoon! He handed you a Revenge of the Sith question, you edgelord, from the Darth Plagueis model that's written on my shirt, and you still won, dude? We were trying to help you, bud!
Cut the music. Look. For a literal week and like a day in real life. This is a shoot. This is not a promo. This is a shoot. I have been in group chats being nice to this guy, coddling this guy, doing everything that this guy wants. He wants nice. He wants excitement and support, and I gave it to him, and he shit on me the entire time. He shit on me the whole time. In front of all of our closest friends for trying to be nicer to him. And I set him up. I tried to buff his powers. And then what? Here we are. I wore the baby. I did the thing with the glasses. I sang the song. And for what, you fucking rube? This is justice. This is Jared win number six, seven. I don't even... Kaysen, there's a spot for you here at Chungus. There's a spot for you over here. You can wear the old ones. You can have these. Mm-hmm. This is just.
So I'm going to quickly remove Jared and Kaysen for a second. Please let them
cope and seethe in the corner over there.
The band-aid
and
has been ripped off.
Relish in our victory. The Chungus is eternal, my friend.
Look, man. Maybe if he had sealed the deal, we would have actually started to embrace some of that mushy bullshit, but he didn't.
Your record is now at a whopping 4-1 as you go into the most important match of your career so far, the title match against the Cannon Junkie in later May.
Heard of me.
What is your mindset off this win on going against the Cannon Junkie in 7 rounds in May?
Regrettable, and I'll tell you why. I know Jerry, the Cannon Junkie. I know him as the Cannon Junkie. I also know him as my beloved Gerald, who since 1945 has broadcast on the Bombad Radio Hour, now known as the Bombad Cast. And now, because of the way things have shaken out, because Jared couldn't rise in the ranks, Jerry, like a true hero, is going to have to step up. But unfortunately, EC, unlike Star Wars itself, is not a fairy tale. And even though I have great respect for Jerry's daughter, his little girl, who has impeccable taste in film, television, Olive Garden menu selections, this kid is the future. Unfortunately, despite my adoration for this little woodland elf of a kid, I'm going to have to send her daddy home battered and bruised. I'm going to have to send her dad home embarrassed. And then maybe Scotty can pick him up and then they, I don't know, do a herky-jerky. Then they both feel better and we move on. Because they are capable of moving on, unlike the people that we trounced today.
Daddy ain't bringing home the gold, just the as-is.
All right, well, we'll both be sure to see you for that title match. Now, let's go to the Jedi Lords.
How are we doing, guys?
Jared, I want to ask you about... just as I asked them about an upcoming match, I want to ask you about an upcoming match.
Yeah.
How is this going to inform your next match, which is our next time match that I will quickly pre-promote now against Brennan Mystical Mar?
I'm very excited for it. You know, I said this in the last match. I'm already getting texts from Scotty. The future is the future. Let me say a couple things real quick. They want to talk about the love of the game. They want to talk about coddling. you know, nobody in this room came in here thinking that anything falling out of the word holes of Alden and Michael was sincere for a fucking second. Because there's not a sincere bone in their fucking bodies. Alden's coming in here. I guess he doesn't want to look up to CM Punk anymore. So, you know, he's coming out here acting like The Rock, trying to be the final boss. I have a final boss, and I'm going to face him in Japan. But again, that's the future. I can either... I'm going to quote the great Nelson Mandela. I don't lose. I win or I learn. I'm like fucking Doomsday from the DC universe. You can't kill me the same way twice. Okay? I am taking people who the league has discarded just like me, and we're all learning together. We're forging, we're not forging steel, we're forging motherfucking Beskar, man. Okay? So how does that make me feel going into my next match against Brennan Maher? It makes me feel invigorated because now I've improved. I've gotten stronger here tonight. And Kaysen's got a baptism by fire because he played against two of the best of the league that has to offer. At very once.
True. All right. So I'm going to pull back in the winners for a second. Alden and Michael, where can we find you?
Please, Alden, go first.
Yeah, I mean, you can find me lots of places. Living rent-free in Jared's mind, living in an actual, like, civilized area and not Latrobe.
Tunisia.
Tunisia. Yeah, I mean, wherever winners go, that's where I am. Fucking look me up. How many Alden Diazes do you know? Not many. So if you can't put that effort in, then maybe you belong in the Wayseeker Alliance.
You can find me on Twitter at Local First Order. You can find me on YouTube, All Remaining Systems. I do a Star Wars RPG series that features Alden, Jerry, Jared, Dan from Bro Axiom. It's a great time. We all love it. It's one of the few ways that Jared can win because I let him. I also write Star Wars fan fiction, which Jared doesn't read. Maybe he would do better if he read them.
It has all the answers.
All right. And Jared and Kaysen, where can we find you?
You can find us not being the human personification of a fucking crypto scam over at the Not Academy podcast. What'd you say?
Heard that.
It's just I've never met people who just exude so much Sam Bankman-Fried energy in my life. Like it's like you took Sam Bankman-Fried and Dino Reynal and fucking Elon Musk and put them in all into one scum fuck huckster carny bastard. But yeah, Ionized Basterds, which I carry, and the Nerd Academy podcast, and here, snatching that belt off of Alden's shoulder once I get my turn in line.
Find me here, despite the amount of hate mail that I'm going to get from Scotty and Alden specifically. Of hate mail.
It's not worth reading. Listen,
it's not.
Listen, when you get a hate mail letter written in crayon and or shit, it's not worth reading. It's not worth reading.
All right. And that was that. Then we reached the end now of a momentous match, truly in ways I didn't think it was going to be. Of course, we already started promote our next match, which is, of course, Jared the Dark Jedi versus Brennan Mystical Maher. If Jared wins, I have promised him as the commissioner a number one contender shot to be held at a later date. And then we do not have the graphic yet for our late May match, but live on the In a Galaxy YouTube channel. Live, 7 rounds to the finish. The Iconoclast, Alden Diaz, the Cannon Junkie, Jerry Cable. 7 rounds to the finish. Our first ever live showcase of the 7-round format. Yes, we've added 2 rounds to our championship format, which we had some great. I'll shout out to Jared the Dark Jedi, and Scotty Jaro for helping us test those two. I'm very excited for everybody to see these new rounds and how they will impact the game going forward. Boop, where can everybody find you?
You can find me huddled in the corner, like, just rethinking my life and my choices. I might want to buy some Death Sticks after this, you know? You can find me also on Twitter, I guess, if you're into that sort of thing, at Boopenheim MEW. Don't look. I'm a shell of the person I used to be.
All right. You can find me at OGFan327 everywhere. Linktree. My Linktree is linktr.ee/_OGFan327. You can listen to Star Wars in a Galaxy. You can listen to Star Wars in a Galaxy everywhere on all the platforms. Please leave a like, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and click that notification bell to make sure that you stay updated on all future Epic Confrontations streams and videos. I think if there's nothing else, all there's left to say is may the Force be with you always.